Hey tankers, welcome back to channel. Today we've got the epic Sunday Best episode 60. I'm gonna call this one the Day of the Minotaur because this last week we had the new Italian TV line featuring the Tier 10 Minotauro released, and we've got a couple aces for you here, and we're gonna start our video off with those. So sit back, grab some coffee, grab a donut, some orange juice, maybe some pancakes and bacon. Let's sit down and watch this video together. Here we go. We're going to start with Denny Pritchard in the Cantarascaro 3 Minotauro. Throw out my best Italian bullshit accent there for you. So we can see he is here on... Excuse me. Canal, and right away he set himself up. He loads one shell and fires. Now, I do not own this tank. I'm only on the tier 7 of the line, but I know these guns are they're a little bit different. They're not called technically Blitz is not calling them auto loaders or auto reloaders, which they're not. It's called to have like a reserve shell, and you look at it in the gun, when you unlock the gun, it calls it a reserve shell gun or something like that. Kind of weird, but so you have one really long reload for your first shell in the clip. Then you have a second reload, which is a bit shorter, and then your third, which is the shortest. Now, this plays on the strategy of using the autoloader guns with a three shell magazine. Of your best reload time with these guns is going to be only by only firing the first shell or the last shell in the clip, letting it reload, and then firing it again. And only in extreme situations do you dump all three shells, usually to save your ass or finish off game or finish off an opponent when there's nobody around you, stuff like that. I'll leave that to you to figure out the best time to use it, but those are typically what you're going to be looking at, your best time to use it. He's got good cover. We saw early on he was firing one shell, reloading, and it was just the first shell in the clip, which is not the way you need to do it. And I think pretty quickly he picked up on what he was doing wrong, and he changed that, and he went into how, you know, he should be playing this. And Denny's a smart player, and this is a new tank, and, you know, as you're playing it every game, you're going to be learning more and more, and I think that's just what's happening. But, so here we go. He's went ahead in a situation, he's fired all three shells. He's trying to keep people alive on his team and keep things going. That's okay because, you know, his team's up by one tank, and he's got a long reload now. He's got one shell in. Now the next two shells, if you watch the shell icon there in the middle of the screen, that will, it'll be a shorter reload. And it goes like, so the reload isn't just the 9 seconds or 5 seconds or whatever the heck it is. It does like the inner shell reload and then the shell reload. So it actually, like if it says it's like a, for example, 5 seconds, it's actually 5 seconds plus the intershell load, which is like another 4 or 5 seconds or whatever that is. But I'm not sure those exact numbers, don't hold me to them, but that's basically how it works. So, you know, you still have a decent reload when you're just firing one shell. It will definitely make you somewhat more competitive than other TDs if you're just firing one shell. But, you know, again, you're going to have to be careful because, you know, if you dump all three shells and you're against somebody who your opponent is not another Minotauro, like Denny is facing right here, they are going to come at you hard. And if you fired all three shells and didn't kill them, you're going to be giving it up for like 25, 26 seconds before you have a shell to fire back at that guy. And that's not a situation to be in at any point. Denny plays a great game here. This is, I think, the first day the tank was released. Pulls out a really nice ace, 4,064 damage, 132,000 credits. A really nice ace there. Great job, Denny. Love seeing it. I know we're going to see more out of you in these tanks. I've got more videos from you already in the queue that I've recorded and haven't recorded. And anyways, we're getting the next one. Archangel in the Contracaro 3 Minotauro. Spaghetti-o. Okay, we're going to go into the next one, guys. And obviously, this is Alistair, a.k.a. Archangel. He is on Fort Despair this time. Actually, I will have another Fort Despair game coming at you, not by Alistair or in the Minotauro, but coming up next. But anyways, so let's focus now this game more on the play style. So it's got, I don't know how much gun depression it has, but if it's like the Tier 7, it's got probably about 7 degrees. Six or seven degrees. I think it's got more than six. It's probably 7 degrees. So that's not going to put you in a play style of playing like on a ridge, although, a shallow ridge, you might get away with it. But you're going to want to keep your bottom plate hidden. From everything I've seen on these tanks so far in game, the bottom plate is the weakest point you're going to get away with things. And that's just going to be, all you can do is, be trying to protect that lower plate. And if you're fighting them and you're front on, and they have that bottom plate hidden, get behind cover and go somewhere else, because, the armor on these things in the front is just ridiculous. And the tier 8 is absurd. Starting at the tier 7, that's absurd. The amount of armor in those things, it's just ridiculous. I was playing the tier 6 this week, really enjoying that tank, and I'd see a tier 7 in front of me, and he'd turn his gun sideways. I couldn't pin him head on. He'd turn his turret sideways to where I'll get a side shot in. All red. And I say, okay, well, I'll load heat. Nope, still all red. And that's the tier 7, and I'm pretty sure this kind of armor profile carries all the way through the tanks. Here we see Archangel put a great shot into the side of that tank. He gets caught out and taken by one of his teammates. So you do not want to face these tanks head on. Adversely, if you're driving the tank, you want to be facing your opponents head on. I know they say that about a lot of tanks, but if you are looking at the armor that I'm looking at when you're facing these things, it's ridiculous. The armor head-on is very OP in my opinion. I'm not calling this tank OP. I'm calling the armor from the front is OP, because so far anything I've driven, I can't pin it from the front, and that's ridiculous. And I know that you shouldn't be counting on pinning tanks from the front, but usually you're in something big enough, it'll pin it from the front. I've not seen it with a Death Star or a bit like a Jaegeru or something with a lot of pin up front. So I don't know. But anyways, Archangel finishes off a great game here. He's going to finish with 3,317 damage, 3 kills, the nice ace mastery, and Wait for it. So he has a great game. All around, he has a great game. Nice job, Alistair. Love seeing it, dude. Keep it going. That's going to bring us to our second game on Himmelsdorf. Sherno Alpha in the FV-215B Death Star in his first ever ace in this tank. So congratulations on your first ace on this tank, Sherno. We're going to watch you cruising around and heading to the D base. He's got a little bit of help there. Now, this is the original Big Daddy TD, and I almost kept this whole video on TDs, but I didn't, because my final game is going to be not in a TD. But this is an old school OG TD in the game. Big gun, big damage, big alpha, big everything. You do not want to get hit by this guy. You do not want to be in front of him. His weakness, of course, is his crap armor and the long ass reload. But if this tank is played in the right way, in the right place, with a lot of cover and somewhere to hide and teammates around you, it's scary. And we saw Sherno put a nice snapshot into that guy, into the top hatch of that tank. He gets finished off, and Sherno's going to go ahead and move right on down the line, go right towards the next targets, get his reload done while he's moving, and watch for somebody to be stupid enough to jump in front of him. He's going to go right past the base there. Doesn't need to cap it. He's looking more to pump some damage out with as long as his reload is. You don't really want to wait on taking shots and capping bases and stuff, and that's really not a TD's responsibility anyways. There he has a Minotauro in front of him behind a building. Can't get a shot on him. He's looking for shots between buildings, but it's just not there. So wisely, he's going to keep moving forward, looking for targets. Get back in them train tracks there and hopefully get himself some targets. Here he's looking out, and he has a... There's a Sheridan pulling out, and boom, big shot. Sheridan goes down for Sherno's first kill of the game. Nice game, nice shot there. So he goes back into his reload. He's got three targets still in front of him, and plenty of health here. He's not even really, he's taking a hit, but nothing serious. Here's a big 1,300 point Hess shot into that LT, 100 LT. That hurt. He loses a partner. It's down to 2-on-2, but those tanks are hurting bad. We got one that's easily one shot for pretty much anybody in the game. Here, that looks like that's the Tier 9 Chinese TD, I think. He pulls out and gets a huge shot in his bottom lower plate as Sherno's partner pulls around to take the kill shot. We now have the Chieftain Mark 6 that's left. Sherno's is gonna, he's finishing his reload. He's got plenty of armor to deal with this guy. He can't get killed in one shot. Puts a nice shot there, Hessian, right to the front plate, finishes off that tank, finishes off that game, gets himself an ace. Really nice game there, Sherno. Congratulations again on your first ace in this tank. You put out 4,547 damage with two kills, ace mastery, and he made 148,000 credits in the game. That's a great game. Nice job. This one will bring us to Climber in the BC, the Batchat Barrasque. Now, you'll notice there's somebody platooning with him. That happens to be me. My two favorite people in the game to platoon with are my brother, who we have been platooning together since we've been playing the game, since he's been playing the game. And we kind of know each other like the back of our other's hands. We know what each other's going to do, and we have great games when we play together. The other one is Climber. Climber and I the other night were just going crazy in bat chats. I think we must have played easily 15 or 20 games in a bat chat just running around, and this was one of them. Love the bat chat. It's got to be my favorite medium right now in the game, as Climber loves to tell everybody it's got the best camo rating in the game at Tier 8. It's better than light tanks even, and it has a camo rating while it moves, which usually only light tanks do. This thing is ridiculous. It's not invisible, but it's pretty damn near when the game. So you already got a great camo rating, you add a camo net to it, and you add a camo to it, and you've made this tank really hard to track. It puts out two massive shots from its clip, then it goes into a not too bad reload, and its speed is such that you can really relocate really quickly, like Climber is doing right here. And you can see I'm right behind him. I'm just, you know, the best way to play with Climber is follow him and you know, help take out his scraps. What he doesn't hit and he can't finish, you hit and you try and finish him. I mean, that's platooning right there. Platooning 101. So, Climber puts two great shots in there. He's looking for his first kill. He's got this guy down here at the end. He's on a reload again. I am right here by Climber. I'm not sure what I'm doing at this point. I'm probably engaging somebody else. Here Climber's going to come up. He's got two shells. There's one. There's two. His first kill of the game. I just raced past him. I was looking to try and get in here and help him. We got another tank there that I was fighting, the Pharaoh. So now I'm trying to back away from the Pharaoh. I don't want to take another hit. I took a lot of damage right there, and I do take another hit. Puts me down to a one shot. Another teammate comes around and takes that kill. The shot there. There's a shot from Climber. There's another shot from Climber. And he is up to over 3,700 damage already in this game. Still three targets left. Plenty of hit points to go around. We lose a tank, and it's now 2-3. Climber and me against the world. Now Climber evens it up. And I'm a one-shot, and I'm just going to be trying to... I'm just trying to add shots in wherever I can to help Climber, because... I'm not, I know, look at one of them's full hit points over there. That's the tier eight new TD. I don't know the name of it, but that's tier eight one. And that's a bastard. Let me tell you, that's front plate in that thing is so friggin' small. Here's where I die. I'm trying to get out of there and I put a shot out, but I got killed. But yeah, that tier eight of the Italian TDs is just a bastard. It's tough as nails. I can't wait to play it. It supposedly, from what I've heard, it's supposed to be the best in the line. So I don't know that. I've not played it. I've only faced it in combat. And I know from the front, it's red as hell in anything I've played against it. So it's not a tank, I think, that you want to face from the front. That being said, he's got a lot of hit points left. Climber is doing everything he can. He's taking a chance to get unspotted. Now he's unspotted. He knows the other guy's unspotted. But he's got a better view range. He's got better camo. So it's about, at this point, taking the time. He's got 2 minutes left on the clock. He needs to take the time to spot this guy and be careful about it, because that guy has got three shells he could dump on Climber, which would then end the game if he didn't end Climber, because he'd be bait, you know, dog bait right there if he didn't finish Climber with three shells. As long as his reload is, Climber would annihilate him. But here we see the guy drove into the cap. Number one mistake at this point. I mean, seriously, you give away your position. There's no way possible that with the time left, you're going to cap and get 100 points cap, let alone, you know, fight a little medium tank that has enough hit points left to take you down. Climber gets a great spot on him here, takes his time, gets in a good, he's going to get a good shot in right there under the side of the turret. He gets spotted, he's going to back down, he's going to reload his shells, give himself some protection, and wait to see what happens with just reset. The guy stays on base. He's giving himself a chance to reset camo. He's going to come at him from a different angle. And he's flanking around here where he knows he'll have side shots. And then it's going to be a matter of out reloading and, you know, dodging shots and putting damage in. He can take one shot from that tank, I think. One side shot, two side shots. Climber pulls forward, gets two shots in, goes into a reload, knocks that guy down to a one shot. Now it's just a matter of who can reload first, and there's, you know, time is ticking. It's going to be close here, guys. It's going to be really close. He, Climber takes a shot. That's it. Game over. He comes in, puts a shot in that, right in that one gray spot he can get it in, picks up the final kill of the game with six seconds to go in the countdown. Climber does one hell of a job. He puts out 5,526 damage with four kills. High caliber. It just Radley Walters. No, that's not Radley Walters. Told Top Gun. Great game. Hey, great game there, guys. What? Star Wars? World War II? Thanks for watching, guys. Hey, until next week. Good luck and good hunting. We will see you soon. See ya.